In October, every team has a dream. And as California rivals collide, only one can turn that dream into reality. Last night in LA, the star-powered Dodgers delivered.
Shohei Ohtani arrives in October!
Tonight, for these rivals, the stakes are rising. The Dodgers can seize a decisive lead, but the surging Padres have other plans.
This is as hot of a rivalry as there is in baseball.
Who takes the next step toward a dream October? Game 2 of the NLDS starts right now on FS1.
Well, it took Shohei Ohtani almost 900 games to get to the postseason. What happened when he arrived? He put the place on its ear. A big home run in the Dodgers' Game 1 win. Ohtani getting ready to face his boyhood idol, Yu Darvish, in moments. Jackson Merrill's going to get some votes for National League Rookie of the Year. What a season he had. A big part of San Diego's ascent to get to where they are now. Welcome back inside. We have a few moments before we get you out to the ballpark. We'll start our predictions with the guy who told us earlier that he has 9 Dodgers jumpsuits. Who wins today,
D-Train? Man, I still got 4 checks left on my deal, so I got to pick the Dodgers tonight.
And you deserve an extension.
That's right.
You deserve an extension. I'm going with the Padres. I think it's another high-scoring game. I want to see it go 5 games, so I'm picking the Padres tonight.
The shadows are going to be a big issue today, so expect a lot of breaking balls. The key for the Padres to win is get the 8th and 9th hitter out. I like Darvish and the Padres.
Hold on. Who's texting me right now? Ohtani? Hey, puppy, I'm going to be a one-man land today. I got to go Dodgers.
All right. Split right down the middle, getting text from Ohtani right before game time. Let's get you out to Dodger Stadium, and the guys
are
on the game.
Hey, he just texted me, man. What are you going to do?
John Smoltz, take it away, boys.
They're revved up for game 2 as we welcome you to the 2024 National League Division Series on FS1 presented by Booking.com. Dodgers and Padres, game 2 after the Dodgers took a thrilling game 1, 7-5. They head down to 5 to San Diego after this one for game 3 coming up on Tuesday night. We welcome inside Joe Davis, the Hall of Famer John Smoltz, the starter last night's game, all too familiar for the Dodgers. They fall into that big hole, but the way they responded was different. You said it before the game today, they may have to out-hit the starting pitching problems, and that's what they did yesterday.
Yeah, well, they dug a hole, and they got out of the hole with their offense. That's a problem that's been in the postseason in the past. It wasn't a problem last night. And for the Dodgers to flex their muscles, they're going to have their star do what he did. What a show he put on. His first postseason, he hits a home run, and I'm going to tell you something right now. If the bottom of the order keeps getting on, the Dodgers have a chance to go all the way.
Padres, John, the clearest advantage for them in this series is the starting pitching head-to-head, but last night, Dylan Cease gives up 5 runs. Yu Darvish has to be a whole lot better today.
He does. They have a balanced team, but their strength is their starting pitching because it gives them depth, and then they can use that bullpen. Yu Darvish knows the Dodgers. He's had success against the Dodgers. He has to pitch into the 5th inning. I know there's a day off tomorrow, and you can see all the numbers. They speak for themselves. But he has to make a statement so the bullpen can do their job.
We were both watching the first game. These National League playoffs are incredible. That Phillies-Mets game back and forth. Hopefully this one's a little bit like last night and that one we saw to begin the day on FS1. Game 1 in Los Angeles delivered in so many ways. The stars were out, the stars delivered. One of them responding to the boos, and one of them, as he's done so many times, meeting the moment and sparking a Dodger win in Game 1. Now in Game 2, the Padres turn to Yu Darvish to try and get this series tied at a game apiece. As Jack Flaherty counters for the Dodgers, it's the National League Division Series. Game 2, next on FS1. You make a trip to Los Angeles, no shortage of places to go see, cross off the list, but there's also no question where the place to be is these days. Dodger Stadium, 1000 Vin Scully Avenue, the site of Game 2. of this National League Division Series and another perfect night for it. 81 degrees, a light breeze as the Dodgers and Padres get ready to rock. We take a look at tonight's same game parlay available now on FanDuel. A couple of these things happened in yesterday's game. Jackson Merrill walked twice, Shohei Ohtani homered, Mookie Betts had a couple walks, didn't drive anybody in. Could they string those together today? Joe Davis, John Smoltz, and as always, down in the field. Hello, Ken Rosenthal.
Joe, Jack Flaherty's average fastball velocities in his last two starts were his lowest of the season. His fastball command wasn't all that great either. Now, one of those starts was against the Padres, and they chased him after five innings. Flaherty told me he wasn't worried. He made adjustments when he experienced similar dips during his time with the Tigers. Well, tonight it is critical he reverses this trend, or this series could be even as it moves to San Diego. The Dodgers bullpen last night threw six scoreless innings. A repeat performance tonight against the game's best contact offense would appear unlikely. Joe.
All right, Kenny, and what a moment this is for the Los Angeles native, traded to his hometown team at the deadline. He's gone 6-2 in his 2 months with the Dodgers and now gets the ball for game two.
Well, he's a great athlete, and he has that mound covered both defensively and with his arm. But the key, I still think, can he throw enough fastballs for strikes? Can he get outs with his fastballs? Because primarily, he loves to rely on the breaking ball. The slider and the curveball are going to be a weapon. But against a team, like Kenny said, this team is so disciplined to the plate, he's going to have to throw enough strikes to beat him.
Yeah, and to your point, he just saw these guys in his last start. He threw a career-high 36 curveballs. And going five innings in that game, giving up three runs. 7-5 Dodgers in game one. Off we go in game two, and it's a fastball away.